गुड मॉर्निंग माय क्लास 10 स्टूडेंट. इन माय पास्ट वीडियो आई हैड कंप्लीटेड द चैप्टर इलेक्ट्रिसिटी एंड मैग्नेटिज्म. सो इन दिस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू सॉल्व द वर्कशीट व्हिच विल प्रोवाइडेड विद दिस वीडियो एंड इन अ पीडीएफ मैनर. नाउ फर्स्ट थिंग फर्स्ट आई वांट टू मेंशन फ्यू थिंग्स. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल इन पीडीएफ यू विल सी फर्स्ट this kind of question paper given over there, 4-page question paper just like worksheet as you know. After that on the 5th page onwards answer given over there. So you will download all the things. Now you listen the video. First you download the PDF, then you listen the video, understood it properly. Now when you will start copying in the copy in your classwork copy, what you will do? First you will copy question from here, then turn page 5, answer from there. If you understood, then copy answer. Question, answer, question, answer. For your sake of convenience, first I had given the whole worksheet, then I had given all the answers. Clear? So let's begin with the explanation of all the answers and question. First question from electricity magnetism chapter. First one is the MCQ. The fuse wire is connected with main line of house wiring in, there are options, parallel combination, series combination, series parallel combination or parallel series combination. So if it is a fuse wire, then what is the purpose of use of a fuse wire? Obviously we are using fuse wire to protect home appliances or office appliances. So if there is any extra, there is occurring any extra passes of charge, extra generation of charge or current which might be affecting the instrument, that will be cut down from the main line. That's why fuse wire roller is connected in series. So that will be option 3, series combination. Coming for the next, energy efficiency ratio for an air conditioner is defined as, what is air conditioner? Air conditioner is a cooling machine. So actually energy efficiency ratio means how much good the AC or bad the AC is, how could I determine? How much for cooling the room, how much watt is used and what is the power consumption by the machine means to cool this room. Suppose it is a 100 square feet room, to cool this room how much watt is utilized and obviously, what is the power consumption? So, energy efficiency ratio is the user ratio of these two. So, options are energy efficiency ratio or EER. Remember, energy efficiency ratio actually written as EER. Energy efficiency ratio, options are cooling capacity into power consumption. Only cooling capacity, option B, only cooling capacity. C is cooling capacity by power consumption and D is 1 by power consumption. AC means it will cool and as well as it is consuming the power from main power supply. So obviously energy efficiency ratio always determined by that ratio of cooling capacity divided by the power consumption. So option will be C. Next one. If the potential difference between the ends of a wire of a fixed resistance is double, by how much does electrical power increases? So suppose this one is a circuit. So this is a complete circuit. So potential difference, this is the voltage power battery or potential difference used. So potential difference between the end of a wire of a fixed resistance. So R is fixed. R is not changing. So, double means first V1 equal to V, then V2 equal to twice of first, double. So, how much the electrical power has been increased? Clear? How much electrical power has been increased? We know V equal to IR. From which law? From Ohm's law we know that V equal to IR, no confusion. Therefore, here V1 equal to I1R because according to the question resistance is not changing. So V1 equal to given how much? V equal to I1R. Clear? V equal to I1R. Second times it is V2 equal to I2R. V2 equal to how much? Twice of V. So 2V equal to I2R. Twice of V equal to I2R. No confusion, I think. Now, from here I will get I1. From here I will get I2. So let's go for that. So I2 equal to 2V by R. And I1 equal to V by R. We know power equal to P1 for the first case equal to V1 I1, and for the second case P2 equal to V2 I2. For the first case P1 equal to V1 I1, for the second case P2 equal to V2 I2. So put other things. So it is V into V by R, and here it is twice V into twice V by R. So it is V square by R, and here what I am getting? 4 of V square by R, means if potential difference becomes double, then power will be how much? 4 times. Let's see the options. Options given are here. 2 times, 4 times, 0.5 times remain unchanged. Obviously, option B will be the answer. Now coming for the 4. A DC generator based generator, DC generator, not motor. DC generator is based on the principle of, options are electromagnetic induction, magnetic effect of current, heating effect of current, electrochemical induction. What do you think, student? Obviously, it is electromagnetic induction, because it depends on Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction, as I started earlier in my past classes. So it is electromagnetic induction, option A. Now coming for the 5th question, 5. The potential difference between live wire and neutral wire in domestical circuit. The potential difference between live wire and neutral wire in a domestical circuit. Options are 220 volt, 11 kilovolt, 33 kilovolt, 132 kilovolt. Achha. Normally, what is the voltage utilized by us? It is 240 volt or 220 volt, nearly equal to. So, in between live wire and neutral wire. So, in between live means the positive connection, neutral means the negative or zero volt, zero potential. So, what will be the potential difference between these two? How much power supply given by the transformer? It is nothing but 220 volt. Probably option A. Yes, 5, option A. Now coming for the number 6 question. Which of the following property is not suitable for fuse wire? Which of the following property is not suitable for fuse wire? First one, low melting point. Second one, high resistance. Third one, thick and short in length. Fourth one, thin and short in length. What are the characteristics of fuse wire? High resistance, low melting point. So first option, second option, not possible. Third option, thick and short in length. And fourth option is thin and short in length. Clear? So thick and short in length will be obvious, which is not suitable for fuse wire, because if it is thick, there is a huge passage of current, and if it is thin, there is no passage of current. So option A, B, D are the correct option. Which one is the not suitable? Option C. So that number 6 option is C. Next one, Number 7, 1 ampere equal to 1 coulomb per second, 1 newton per meter. Option C, 1 joule per meter, 1 volt per centimeter. 1 ampere current equal to what? Q by T, number of charge per unit time. What is the unit of Q? Q means charge, means coulomb. Time is second. So, unit of 1 ampere, that is coulomb per second, option A will be the answer. Now, coming for 8. Option A, identify the wrong statement. Which one is wrong here? Resistivity of a substance is a characteristic property of material. It is true or false? Obviously, it is true. Means it will not be the answer. Resistivity depends on temperature. It is also true. Unit of resistivity is ohm. Unit of resistivity is ohm. Three options given there. So, resistivity means rho. Clear? Resistivity means rho. We know that. So, if it is rho, then rho equal to R L by A. R means ohm, L means meter, A means meter square. So what is the unit of resistivity? Resistivity's unit is ohm per meter, or in a single word, ohm meter inverse. So the third one is wrong, that is unit of resistivity is ohm. Achha, number 9. The presence of magnetic field at a point can be detected by means of strong magnet, solenoid, a compass needle, a current carrying wire. So, which one is the easiest method? Obviously, a compass means option C. 9 is option C. Now, number 10. The direction of induced current obtained by which law? Options are Fleming's left hand rule, clock rule, right hand thumb rule. Fleming's right hand rule, which one? Direction of induced current or induced EMF. Obviously, Fleming's right hand rule. So, option is D. Next one, number 11. There is a circuit given. Two bulb. This is one bulb. This is another bulb. Clear? So, they are connected in parallel condition, means from the same source they are getting the potential. So, here it is connected at 220 volt. Here it is connected at 220 volt. Clear? This bulb is 60 watt. This bulb is 60 watt. So, proportion is total power consumed by the circuit. Two bulbs getting the same current at a time. What is utilized by this one is 60 watt. This is utilized by 60 watt. So, how much power consume? Obviously, 60 plus 60, 120 watt. So, the answer is option C, 120 watt. Next one. A high tension wire means through this, which wire? The high voltage coming to our locality. That high tension wire has high resistance and high melting point. Option B, low resistance and large surface area. Option C, low resistance and low melting point. So, option will be, that is C, means low resistance, low melting point. If it has low resistance, huge current can flow through it. That is the main purpose of high tension wire. And obviously, low melting point, which protect the circuit. Clear? So, low resistance and low melting point will be the characteristics of the high tension wire. Next, 13. Two fuse wire are rated as 5 ampere and 20 ampere. Which of the two is thicker and longer? So, one fuse wire is 5 ampere. Another fuse is 20 ampere. So, one fuse wire is 5 ampere, another fuse wire is 20 ampere. Clear? So, both the two wires, two is the fuse. So question is, which one is thicker and longer? See, the capability of a fuse wire 5 ampere means at least 5 ampere current can flow. If 5 ampere current is passes through the fuse wire, it is safe for the fuse wire. Clear? So 5 ampere and 20 ampere, large current means more thickness needed. So the 20 ampere will be more thick and long. More thick and long. So option will be B. Option will be B, 20 ampere. Next one, number 14. The rating of a fuse connected in the lightning circuit. Lightning circuit means which protect our house from lightning. Lightning circuit is, options are 15 ampere, 5 ampere, 10 ampere, 0. See, in lightning circuit, remember that the fuse connected with that circuit obviously of 5 ampere, at least 5 ampere. Remember this thing one. You need to remember that. Now, last of MCQ, that is, which one is true for superconductor? See, graph given over there. These are actually conductivity versus temperature curve. We have done already. This is first one. This is second one. And this is the third one. So for superconductor, superconductor means what kind of conductor? Means at a certain temperature, it has increasing of conductivity. Means if you are decreasing temperature, conductivity increases. So option A. So that's all for the MCQ's question. Now I will go for SAQ and LAQ question. Now see, next one is the SAQ and LAQ part of the worksheet. See, whatever be the question given, except few, all the answers you know very well. So either you can copy from there or in PDF, all the answers given, you just copy from there. First one is given, state Coulomb's law. Coulomb's law means what? There are two charges, they are attract each other. The force of attraction or repulsion depends on the distance between them, square inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them, and directly proportional to the product of the magnitude. Then Coulomb's law, it is also given. Achha. Write down Coulomb's equation from the for free space. We know Coulomb's equation is generally, that is F equal to Q1 Q2 by 4 pi epsilon 0 r square. Q1 Q2 by 4 pi epsilon 0 r square. So this epsilon 0 means what? This equation is belongs to free space. So this is the trick of the question. Free space means this equation they need. Also remember that whenever you are writing this equation, first you will write Coulomb's law from free space. For free space is F equal to Q1 Q2 by 4 pi epsilon 0 r square. They clearly mention where Q1 and Q2 are the magnitude of charge, where Q1 and Q2 are the magnitude of charge, 4 pi epsilon 0 is a constant of proportionality, r is the distance between them. Clear? Next one is, give the definition of potential difference from the idea of work done. Give the definition of potential difference from the idea of work done. Now, potential difference, potential is what? Suppose somewhere there is a charge Q plus Q. Here I am having an electric field. So you are bringing that plus Q to this electric field. You are doing a work. So that work equal to what? That work done doing by you is called the potential of that charge. Potential of that charge. Work done is equal to the potential of that charge. Now that charge came here. So here a plus Q charge. Suppose here another one plus Q charge. Or here a point A, here a point B. So within the electric field, suppose you are bringing plus Q charge from here to here. So if you are bringing a charge, you need to do a work done. So within electric field, the amount of work done you are doing, that is called the potential difference. Within electric field, the amount of work done you are doing, that is called potential difference. So whenever it is written that definition of potential difference from work done, so you will write that we know work done in potential difference W equal to VA minus VB into Q. Q is what? Q is the amount of charge, where VA is the potential of this place, VB is the potential of this place. How we will define? The potential difference between two points in an electric field is defined as the amount of work done to bring the charge from one point within the electric field to another point. So that is actually the answer. Next one, write down Ohm's law. Ohm's law, you know, given already here. Ohm's law, you know, if temperature, before that there is a question number 5, that is what is the difference between electromotive force and potential difference. See, when I discuss potential difference and electromotive force side by side, we know in a circuit, suppose this is a circuit, here I am having a voltage V. This is a circuit, this is my total circuit, here it is voltage. So what is the EMF of the circuit? What is the voltage or potential difference of the circuit? So remember that potential difference is what? When the circuit is in closed circuit condition. Means the circuit is in closed, means completely closed, which is begin the current flow. At that time, the difference between potential between any two terminal, that is called the potential difference. And EMF is what? If you are bringing one positive charge throughout the whole circuit, the circuit is in open circuit condition, then that is called EMF. Means what? Suppose I am having an electric cell, it is not connected. So this is suppose an electric cell, this is not yet connected. So at that time its voltage is equal to the EMF. Voltage is equal to the EMF. Now when the voltage is connected to the circuit, now this cell is connected within the circuit, means it's a closed circuit. At that time there is another thing, means in the through the wire the connection is going on, means there are some internal resistance also. So EMF equal to V plus IR. EMF equal to V plus IR. So if you see carefully, potential difference has a less value compared to EMF. Actually, in normal sense, potential difference and EMF, voltage, EMF, both are the same thing. But precise manner, potential difference is the voltage in closed circuit, EMF is in open circuit. This difference is also given there. Next one is, write down Ohm's law. What is Ohm's law? We know, if the temperature and other physical quantity remains constant, potential difference between the two terminals depends on the current flow through it. Given already. Given next one, with the same question, give definition of resistance from the law. As you know, already I stated earlier, whenever a electron is flowing through a conductor, now conductor has already free electron and some ions, everyone vibrate their about their mean position. So when an outside electron from a cell coming to the conductor, it will suffer so many collision throughout the conductor and will travel from one portion to another. So during the propagation of electron, it will suffer some opposing force. That opposing force is nothing but what? That opposing force is nothing but that resistance. So first we will give the Ohm's law. So then you will write, we know that current flowing through a metallic conductor when potential difference across within it, then it is given how the collision occurs, and that collision is the opposing force, that is the resistance. It is given already. We just go through it. And so next one is, express Ohm's law graphically. We know Ohm's law equal to V equal to IR. Ohm's law means V equal to IR. So what will be the graphical representation of Ohm's law? obviously that will be a straight line VI. Means as long as I am increasing voltage, current flow will increase proportionally. Clear? So that is the V equal to IR thing. So V equal to IR voltage versus current. V equal to IR voltage versus current. Or done. Achha. Next one is given. Resistivity of a substance is 1.68 into 10 to the power minus 6 ohm. Resistivity of a substance is 1.68 into 10 to the power minus 6 ohm. What is the meaning of this statement? As I today discussed earlier, resistivity is rho equal to R L by A. Rho equal to R L by A. Suppose I am having a cubical surface. Why I am taking cubical? Telling you. Achha, suppose I am having a cubical surface which is 1 meter length, 1 meter breadth and 1 meter height. So it is a cube. So if I put 1 here, 1, 1, 1, what is remaining R? Means if current flow from this surface to this surface, if current is flowing, if current is flowing from this surface to this surface and this whole cube is one unit dimension, then the resistance offered by the surface is the resistivity of that conductor. So if resistivity is given, suppose a value given here, that is 1.68 into 10 to the power minus 6 ohm. So what I can say, that is if through from one surface to another surface of a cube of 1 meter length, breadth and height, current is flowing between these two surfaces, the amount of resistance is equal to 1.68 into 10 to the power minus 6 ohm. 1.68 into 10 to the power minus 6 ohm. Because what I can see, if other things remain one, then resistivity is equal to the resistance. Resistivity is equal to the resistance. Next one, next question given, what is VOT? VOT already stated earlier, VOT means VOT is equal to board of trade unit. Board of trade unit means it is the unit for electrical consumption which is utilized commercially. Board of trade unit, which is exactly equal to 1 kilowatt hour, which is exactly equal to 1 kilowatt hour. So BOT equal to, first you will write the full form. BOT is equal to board of trade unit. Then you will go for board of trade unit. Then you will go for, that is equal to 1 kilowatt. And if possible, you can write that 1 kilowatt equal to 3.6 into 10 to the power 6 of joule. It is not required. If you can memorize, you can write it down. Achha. Next one, just previously I explained, that is explain Lenz law from the conservation of energy principle. Here in a short form I had given again in PDF. I'm just explaining the answer over here. Explain Lenz law from the conservation of energy principle. What was Lenz law? There is a circuit. Here is a galvanometer. So if a magnet is moving towards the surface, so obviously EMF will generate. So Lenz law stated what? The direction of induced EMF. What will be the direction of induced EMF? The direction of induced EMF will oppose the cause of its generation. Who is the cause of the generation? Here, as you can see, this magnet or changing magnetic flux is the cause of its generation. So whatever may be the current is generating over here, that will oppose the motion of that current. How it is explaining from conservation of energy principle? Conservation of energy principle energy neither be created nor be destroyed. Now suppose you are moving this magnet towards the coil, more and more electric magnetic flux passes through the coil. Now if magnetic flux passes through the coil, so after some times there will be a generation of magnetic field. So what I can see, this side will be the north pole and this side will be the south pole or something else. It is seen that if instead of this side north pole, this side south pole, I am having the opposite pole, then obviously the magnet will move very fast, when magnet will gain a kinetic energy. Now see, here I don't have a current source. The induced EMF generated by this magnet. So if it is not opposing the magnet, then without any source, it will generate a kinetic energy which will be given by this circuit, which is not possible. So that explanation is given over there. Achha. Next one, state Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction, already explaining so many times. That is, as long as magnetic flux is present there, that will be generated, magnetic field will be, EMF will be generated. Then magnitude of the induced EMF is directly proportional to the change in the magnetic flux. In PDF, again I had given. Next one is the mathematics, numericals. Let's go for that. Question number 12. See, in question number 12, it is given two charges, Q and 3Q, means I am having two charges, are placed 20 meters apart from each other in air. If the force of repulsion in between them is 30 Newton, then what is the value of Q? So, let's first draw it. So, here I am having Q1, here I am having Q2. Distance between them is 20 meters. What are the things given? That is Q1 equal to Q, Q2 equal to 3Q, distance R equal to 20 meter and the attraction or repulsion force is equal to 30 Newton. Clear? What I need to calculate? I need to calculate the value of Q. Now three things. First of all, we know according this will be obviously solved by force of attraction or repulsion F equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q1 Q2 by R square. 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q1 Q2 by R square. No confusion. Now remember that I said earlier, this you need to memorize. If in question it is not given, you have to memorize. That 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 has a constant value. That constant is 9 into 10 to the power 9 Newton. Very easy to memorize. That is 9 into 10 to the power 9 into Q into 3Q by 20 whole square. Q into 3Q by 20 whole square. Done. I'm rubbing this portion. So, F equal to given how much? F equal to 30 Newton. So this side 30, that is equal to 9 into 10 to the power 9 Q into Q, Q square, 3 Q square by 400. So I need to find out this Q. So Q square equal to 30 into 400 by 9 into 10 to the power 9 into 3. 30 into 400 by 9 into 10 to the power 9 into 3. Now 3 tens are 30. Okay. So it is 4000 by 9 into 10 to the power 9. 4000 by 9 into 10 to the power 9. Now, 4000 means 4 into 10 to the power 3. So, Q square equal to 4 into 10 to the power 3 by 9 into 10 to the power 9. Now, 9 into 10 to the power 9 means these together 3 minus 9 will be 10 to the power minus 6. Means 4 by 9 into 10 to the power minus 6. So, Q equal to root under 4 by 9 into 10 to the power minus 6. Q equal to root under 4 by 9 into 10 to the power minus 6. Now, simply square root. 4 means outside it will come 2. 9 means outside it will come 3. 3 is a 9. Minus 6. Minus 6 means minus 3 minus 3. So, any one minus 3 will be coming. So, minus 3 coulomb. Clear? In PDF it is also given. If you are having any confusion, you can ask me to the comment section. So, this one done. Now, coming for the next one. If a bulb is connected to 220 volt supply, then 1 ampere current is flow through it. Number 13. If the bulb is connected to 110 volt supply, calculate the current flow through it. Clear? So, let's go in for that. Number 13. So, first, what are the things given? Two things. Bulb first connected to 220 volt. So, V1 equal to how much? 220 volt given. V1 equal to 220 volt given. Acha. And current is I1 equal to 1 ampere. It is also given. I1 is equal to 1 ampere. This is also given. Another thing given what? Now the bulb is connected to 110 volt power supply. So right now V2 equal to 110 volt. V2 equal to 110 volt. So I1, they ask us I1. So I2 I need to calculate. Clear question now. So first of all, let's bulb is connected to 220 volt. Now the same bulb is connected for both the circuit, means resistance is same. Clear? Resistance is same. So here the R, both are equal. So from Ohm's law we can write V1 equal to R I1. Yes? And here V2 equal to R I2. V1 equal to RI1, V2 equal to RI2. So, here I will calculate R, that R I will put over here, so I can calculate I2. Because here unknown factors are 2, here unknown factors are 1. So, V1 equal to 220 equal to R into 1. So, R equal to 220 of ohm. That 220 of ohm I will put it here. So, V2 equal to 110 volt put into R. R is how much? R is how much? 220 volt. So, put 220 volt here into I2. That is still unknown to us. So, therefore, I2 equal to 110 by 220 cancel out. So, I am having 11 by 20. 11 by 22 means 1 by 2. I2 equal to 1 by 2 ampere. So, that is equal to 0.5 ampere. 0.5 ampere. So, answer is I2 means the second case I2 is 0.5 ampere. Now, next one. Now, next one is, it is dangerous to connect the switch in neutral wire. It is dangerous to connect in a switch in neutral wear. So in a neutral wear, what is happening actually? Suppose I am having a bulb. Here I am having a bulb. So suppose this is bulb means it is connected to live wear and it is neutral, another terminal connected to neutral wear. So it is seen that instead of connection of switch here, if I am connecting my switch here, means instead of live wear, if I connect my switch, what is happening? It is very dangerous. Why? Because when the switch is in on condition, no problem. So I am switching on the, suppose switch is on here. On means switch is getting the full power, means from here current is coming, from here current is going, no problem. So after that, I make the switch close, off. So if the switch is off, so actually the remaining portion of current cut it from this neutral wear means the current is not getting the return power, but current is coming continuously. Current is not getting its return power, but current is coming continuously. So what is happening? We can see the bulb is in off condition because if the circuit is not closed, the bulb will not glow. If the circuit is not complete one, not closed, the bulb will not glow. That purpose solved by the switch. But the problem is that if in that condition, switching off condition, somehow I want to change the bulb. So I want to remove this. That time 220 volt will give me a fatal shock. Why? Because here continuous current is coming. Since current is not getting its return power, so it is seems to be a switch off a bulb, but it is not actually switch off. So that is actually written over here with circuit diagram. You just go through it. Next one, for earthing an electrical appliance, one has to remove the pin from metallic body of the appliances where the electric contact is made. Explain the reason. What is the reason? So actually pin of an electrical conductor sometimes act as an insulator. So what is the purpose of earthing? Purpose of earthing is that to protect the circuit, from outside lightning, it will not affect the domestical appliances. So for that, I need a continuous passage of the whole electricity. I need a continuous passage of the whole electricity. So if there is an insulator system, so electricity will get blocked. So that high voltage will not get passed properly. That's why before earthing connection, if there is a strong pin, a thick pin, you need to remove that pin. Achha. Next one is state the difference between step up and step down transformer. As we know, step up transformer enhances the EMF voltage. Step down transformer reduces the EMF voltage. In my earlier video, I show you the two diagram. One secondary coil, another primary coil. It is seen that in step up transformer, the number of turns in the secondary coil is more than the primary coil. And in case of step down, it is just the opposite version. So that is another. Next one, the turns ratio, NS by NP. Secondary is to NS by NP. So obviously, if it is a step-up transformer, that NS by NP will be greater than 1. And if it is a step-down transformer, the trans ratio will be less than 1. That's the three difference. That's enough for marking. Next one, number 17. A refrigerator having power rating 350 watt operates for 12 hours a day. Calculate the cost of electrical energy operate for 30 days. Rupees 4.50 per BOT. We had done so many times these things, you know, when I started that power, electricity power chapter. So 350 watt, bulb utilized 350 watt. How much? For 12 hours multiplied means per day it utilized 12 hours. It is consumption happened for 30 days. means part 30 days it is consuming like that. I will multiply the whole things, done the multiplication. After multiplication, what I need to do? I will get the total power watt hour. So I will get multiplication, probably multiplication will 126 probably. Yes, 126 watt hour. Now I need to convert it BOT because I need a commercial unit needed. So watt hour to kilowatt hour means to the division by 1000. So 126,000 by 1000. BOT, this is the BOT. Now per BOT cost is 4.50 rupees. So total electricity bill is what? 4.50 into 126. If I multiply 4.50 into 126, it will be 567. In copy it is given rupees 567 is the answer. Achha, why AC current is used in our home, not DC? See, you can tell me, ma'am, we are using always DC current in every appliance. It is true, but actually from the electric source, electric power station, what is coming? AC, not DC. Why they are not propagating DC? See, as you know, when I started DC generator, there is some complication except AC generator. So AC generator is very cost efficient, means in a low cost I can generate AC. And whenever it's come to our home, there are different uses. Some instrument use DC, some instrument use AC. Clear? So what we are doing, as per our consumption, we are converting that AC into DC. We are not directly using DC, because if I am using AC is there, I can easily convert it to DC, but if DC is there, I can't make it AC. So AC I am taking. That is the commercial aspect. Other aspect are, I am just telling you, written here. The magnitude of AC voltage can easily step up or step down by the transformer. It is cheap and AC can be transmitted over a long distance transmission, but DC can't. So these all are about worksheet. Everything written in PDF. Again I am telling, first write the question, then copy the answer from PDF. All the things given over there. And another thing, this is my earnest request to you. This is a long video. In a compact manner I had done this. Please go through the all videos. Don't skip the videos one after another. Go through the all things. That will help you, I think. Thank you. Electricity magnetism now completed. Next onwards I will start thermal phenomena. And after that I will come, if I am getting time, I will come again for the revision of electricity magnetism chapter. Thank you, class.